Tiwanaku is the name of an ancient civilization that flourished in Bolivia on the shores of Lake Titicaca, a lake so immense that it looks more like the sea. There are numerous ruins on the island of the sun and the island of the moon, where even today people invoke ancient gods, above all the earth mother, Pachamama, and the great creator, Viracocha. Tijai means sit down, and Wanaku means guanaco, a close relative of the South American llama. So although Tiwanaku means sit down, guanaco, this is considered a holy place, and I'm trying not to sit on any sacred rocks. Like any other culture, Tiwanaku had its rise and fall. Legend has it that the god Viracocha was angered by the violence of its people and sent them the gift of a flood that caused Lake Titicaca to overflow and do away with the civilization. Many of the stones here sit facing the mountains where the gods lived so comfortably. One has to wonder how those massive blocks of stone were moved. Were these people giants or extraterrestrials? Even today, many shamans perform their rituals among these stones. It's a deeply rooted custom to appeal to Father Sun and Mother Earth before any important undertaking. All the temples in the capital of Tiwanaku are astronomically oriented with a remarkable degree of precision. Finally, I'm at the site of the famous monoliths, the Ponce monolith and the bearded or Kontiki Viracocha monolith. And the Gateway of the Sun, a stone gate weighing 10 tons. These ruins represent the golden age of Tiwanaku. All over the grounds, there are carved stone heads with features representing different ethnicities. I catch my plane thinking, may Viracocha protect us.